Let's get started with filters. Now filters are really all about processing the incoming data. So something comes in, we can decide to filter something out, we can alter the data, and then pass it on to the reporting views within Google Analytics. There's a lot of different stuff that you can do with filters, and it always depends on how you want to later work with the data. But for a standard setup, a best practice is to simply install one filter, which is the own traffic filter, because you don't want to analyze your own traffic. You want to get insights about your users. So filtering out your own traffic is recommended. And there are really different methods of doing this. Some are not really filters, but we'll start out talking about the IP filter, which is the standard way of excluding your own traffic, but there are some limitations to this approach. We'll talk about plugins, how you can filter out your own traffic with browser plugins that you can install, or the host file approach. And some more advanced techniques would be cookie filtering or implementing that via Google Tag Manager. So let's take a look on how to set this up in Google Analytics. So just to show you here in our admin of our demo account, we have filters available here under our view settings. Once we click on that, we can see all the filters that are implemented. Now, if you click on new filter, we'll have different options here. And this is a very powerful feature because you can not only filter by IP address, but you could also filter out different traffic types, such as people who come from a different host name, subdirectory. Even in the custom view, you have many different other fields that you can filter off, and they can be useful. But for our case right now, we just want to filter the own traffic, which we can easily do by selecting here this filter type and say that we want to exclude the traffic which comes from a certain IP address. And we can choose if we want to exclude a exact IP address, a one that begins with a certain range or ends with a certain range, or that contains certain values. Now, how to go about this? Obviously, you could go into Google, just type in my IP address, and it will give you the IP address. You could copy that and put that into this IP address filter and then say this is equal to, and this is the IP address. We give it a name. And you would be all set and done to have this IP address filter implemented. Now, there's a big but here to take this approach, because my IP address can actually change. If I reconnect to my ISP, there might be a new IP address that is assigned to us. And therefore, this will change, and I would need to change this IP address filter every time I log on to the internet. Now, this approach works pretty well if you have a static IP address. Sometimes this is the case with bigger companies, or if you know your IP address range. So maybe your IP address ranges between several numbers, and you could just say that you want to ask the IP address to begin with. Now, this is really an approach where you really need to know your IP address and how it works. So I wouldn't recommend this approach to anyone who doesn't know exactly how the IP address functions within the organization. If you want to use this approach and have a little bit more granularity in the way you filter these IP addresses, you can also use regular expressions. And this is possible by going to the filter type custom, and then in the IP address field, you can choose a filter pattern. And this is really the regular expression that you can type in. If you want to find more about that, you can look into the help section of Google Analytics, and here you'll find different examples on how to filter the IP address with regular expressions. But as I said, this is really one approach that you can take. There are other approaches out there, not really putting in a filter here, but rather filtering the traffic on a measurement level. So making sure that the data doesn't even get sent to Google Analytics. And the first thing that I can recommend here is using a browser plugin. And we have here Ghostery. So once we install this on our Chrome browser, this is also available for Firefox, we get this little icon here. And once we go to a page and reload that page, we'll be able to see which tags are installed: Google Tag Manager, Google Analytics, Gravata. And we can choose to block this tag on our browser. So once we reload this page, we see that Google Analytics is not active anymore. And within our reporting view, we shouldn't see any activity. Let's go into the real-time reporting, and we see there was no page view triggered. Now, the downside of this plugin is really if you go to another page here and have a Ghostery active, you'll see that Google Analytics gets blocked by default on every page, which makes my heart as a web analyst really squeak, because this user will be not visible for Google Analytics anymore on every page, which is not really a nice approach to handling this problem, but it's a viable method of doing so. Another quick method of excluding your traffic would be editing your host file. So you can go into your system settings of your operating system, such as Windows or macOS, and can find the host file. It's normally under etc hosts for Mac users. And you can put in some blocking rules that will prevent the tracking code to connect to Google Analytics, the Google Analytics servers, and therefore the information won't be sent. Obvious downside, the same as the plugin, this will block Google Analytics on every page and you won't be tracked on any page anymore. Another method that comes to mind, if you are a big organization and you have a central accessing system such as a router, you could set up a filter to not connect to these servers either. But as I said, this is really an easy approach, but at the same time, you won't be tracked for any site anymore, which really hurts the web analytics community overall. Now, the last approach that I want to present here is, first of all, Google Tag Manager. There's a great write-up by the guys at lunametrics.com, how to install filters via Google Tag Manager. This will also prevent the data to actually be sent to Google Analytics. This would go into far too much detail to show here, but what you can essentially do is all the IP filtering can be done on Google Tag Manager side, and you can set up a simple blocking rule so your tag doesn't get fired when somebody with a certain IP address enters the site. And one more approach which could also be implemented via Google Tag Manager is the custom variable approach, or custom dimensions, how they are called nowadays in Universal Analytics. You can send out a custom dimension to a user who is visiting the site, for example, on a specific login page, like on our demo shop here. We have the custom sign-up page, logout, which everybody has to go through who is administrator of this user. So we can identify on this page users that belong to the organization, set a cookie or a custom dimension, send it over to Google Analytics, and then set up a rule within the processing system to filter all these people out that have this custom variable installed. And it's all pretty much explained in this blog post that I will link up in the resource section. So overall, I can just encourage you to look at the different approaches out there, what fits best to the company, to your company, but also to the client's organization, and send over instructions to the client on how to install it and make sure that your tracking is not polluted by your own traffic data.